one, go!
So close.
All right, and we are back with myself and my oldest friend on the mic.
Oh, yo, what's good, y'all? It's me, Ho, hopping on with G-Pick yet again, jumping straight into... Oh, this still is Winter Quarters. Okay.
Yeah. Right now, Jay's Fnatic has been causing a bit of a tear in the bracket, I've noticed, beating a lot of players that are ordinarily seen in top 16.
Oh, they're not ready for Bayonet. No, but aside from just Bayonetta, Jay actually is a really good player. When he's on it, when he is feeling it and he's getting all those conversions, it's Bayonetta. What can you do? Mm-hmm. But when he's a little sloppy, then it's looking pretty bad. But already, great, solid stuff coming out for him so far. But I'm a little upset at this right now because I just spoke to these two gentlemen before I walked up here. They're supposed to be Falco Dittoing.
I am actually happy they're not Falco Dittoing. Because, I mean, like, the Falcon Ditto, it's nice and all, but to me, it's like one layer above. So there's the collusion. That is exactly the sort of punish I like seeing. I am so tired of people letting Bayonetta get away with a little bit too much. I know she's safer than a lot of people. Like, they say, oh, her neutral's bad, but it's actually pretty safe. But people give it a little too much respect. Those perfect pivot F-tilts, though. Oh, Trevante
dropping the conversion right there. Man, he's looking like a junior sheep, but, I mean, void, but, hey.
A junior void.
junior void cheek.
Hey, Void said Trevante best
Sheik. Yeah, dude, yeah. That was the greatest tweet ever.
The funniest thing is, like, after he outplays them at Zero Sog, he said, no, Trevante still best Sheik. Like, it was like, no.
You guys need to learn. No, I know there was a lot of conversation between all the Sheiks of saying who was number three, and Trevante's name came up quite a bit. Mm-hmm. No, but right now, Jay, not looking too bad, trying to jump around, trying to find his footing, but... Trevante just playing his usual play style, getting in there, smothering you, and just limiting all your options.
I've noticed so far with Jay's neutral, his pressure has been very scared, right? Well, he'll poke Trevante, or he'll die.
I mean,
he'll
speaking of scared, die. Like, this man wasn't even trying to grab the ledge. He was like, yo, Trevante's going to touch me. I can't do this.
Okay. But what was I saying? I noticed he was like poking Trevante's shield, and like, he did witch twist. Like, he was that scared of a punish coming immediately and was trying to escape. Which is understandable given the memory that he afterburner kicked up and then immediately was punished by Diamond Cutter up smash. But when you're playing that scared, that essentially let Trevante hold full control of the stage, and he kept burning his resources to stay in the air longer, which means that when you touch the ground as Bayo, your lag's just going to be longer at the end of the day.
Yep. I mean, the only saving grace that Bayonetta has when you are going to be landing after you do your Witch Twist and the afterburner kick is Witch Time.
Yeah.
And that could have helped him in a couple of situations, but again, he's playing scared. But if you're scared, you know, why not throw out that best counter in the game? But I actually really do like the mix-up that he did on Trevante.
That was pretty nice. Yeah, making it look like he wanted to retreat to the Smashville platform. Trevante being a fast-witted enough player to immediately try to catch on to that and block it.
Interesting. So I didn't go for the afterburner kick. Not sure nerves or what, but Jay is just dropping a couple of things. I'd love to see him kind of do a little bit more. And it all starts with that. Once you get a couple of these hits going in.
Hey, he's just finding straight hits right now. We're not seeing the classic sort of Bayonetta custom combo, make a bear sort of things.
No, Trevante going a little bit too deep right there. Charging up the needles, but reverse hit of the up. So close to getting the bouncing glitch. But the one thing that Jay is doing phenomenally at is that he's been avoiding a bunch of stuff, but... He's getting dragged down right now.
Yeah, he's avoiding a lot of stuff, but he's not, like, punishing all that stuff, right?
No, there's no avoidance right there. Needles into the bouncing fish? That's a Sheik classic.
He's spending a lot of time, like, he's putting so much effort into not being hit by stuff that he's just putting him in position to eventually be hit by something. Like, he only has 34% on the board. Like, sure, he's been living for a long time. But right there, right? He used four air specials all the time in the world for Durante to drop shield and forward tilt time. And once again... Just dead off the stage. Poor Jay's Fnatic. Unfortunate stuff. I mean, it is hard, of course, to play on the aggressive against the Sheik player. I don't mean to make that sound easy. Like, yeah, just be bold and press buttons. It's Sheik.
No,
like, obviously,
challenge her.
Yeah.
It's not like she has phenomenal frame data or anything.
Yeah. But on a